Hi everyone, I'm Jennifer, a PhD student from Caltech. I will be talking about our work on self-supervised keypoint discovery, which enables the study of single or multi-agent behavior in videos with quasi-stationary backgrounds. Behavioral video analysis is crucial in many fields, such as for studying model organisms in scientific experiments. These behaviors can then be used to understand neural activity or the effects of different drugs for pharmacological evaluations. For user applications, behavioral videos can capture human behavior for human-robot interactions, as well as for healthcare monitoring. In all cases, video data is recorded at a large scale, and the goal is to automatically quantify behavior from video. Existing methods for behavioral video analysis often perform pose estimation that map poses to behavior. Pose is a good intermediate step because it is low dimensional, which enables interpretability as well as modularity. There are many works using pose for behavior, generally with supervised keypoints. Another relevant direction is keypoint discovery, where conditional image generation is an inspiration for our work. This work extracts appearance features from image X and keypoints from image X prime in order to learn informative keypoints to conditionally generate X prime. There are many other works studying the relationship between pose and image appearance. To the best of our knowledge, there has not been studies at the intersection of these areas. Behavioral video analysis generally use supervised pose estimation, requiring potentially time-consuming or expensive keypoint annotations. On the other hand, many works in keypoint discovery require agent bounding boxes, which requires a trink detector on real-world videos. This is especially difficult for multiple agents. Our work on behavioral keypoint discovery is at the intersection, where our goal is to directly discover keypoints from behavioral videos without manual keypoint or bounding box annotations. Bkind is able to do this in a variety of settings, including diverse organisms and multiple agents. Our method is based on the idea of discovering locations with maximum movement information. Let's look at a simple example. Given a rigid object, such as a pencil here, if we had two keypoints, we can reconstruct the new location and orientation using these keypoints alone. We can try to do the same with scissors. However, since the scissors have one joint, these keypoints are not enough to disambiguate whether it is closed or open. We need an additional keypoint to fully reconstruct the movement. There are also many other options on where to place these three keypoints. Once we move to real-world videos, there are even more degrees of freedom, making it difficult to define and annotate keypoints. Bkind learns these keypoints using self-supervision. We start with two frames in a behavioral video at time t and t plus k, and we run our keypoint discovery model on both frames. The location for each keypoint is computed using a spatial softmax for a heat map channel. Then the keypoints go through a decoder to reconstruct movement across frames t and t plus k. Since the keypoints are sparse and may not encode all visual details, we also encode appearance features of the image at time t. The input to movement reconstruction is appearance features and keypoints at time t, and only keypoints at time t plus k. The model is self-supervised using spatiotemporal difference reconstruction to the real agent movement between t and t plus k. Results show that our model is general and works across a variety of agent types, from mice to flies, humans, jellyfish, as well as trees. Comparing our spatiotemporal difference reconstruction to image reconstruction, we see that the keypoints discovered by our model qualitatively tracks parts more consistently. Additionally, for downstream behavior classification, our keypoints are quantitatively comparable to supervised keypoints trained on this data set. Since Bkind doesn't require any human annotations, it can be applied directly to any behavioral video with quasi-stationary backgrounds. This can quickly provide keypoints for prototyping, but there is little control over the keypoints, and our keypoints can be sensitive to occlusion. Another potential use case is Bkind in a semi-supervised setting. The self-supervised part from Bkind can improve data efficiency of the supervised annotations. However, the best location to track for a given video setup may not be clear ahead of time. Therefore, Bkind can also be used in a human-in-the-loop setup to give feedback on which keypoints are easily discoverable. Then users can adjust discovered keypoints and retrain. There are many other ways to use Bkind, and we have open sourced our code. We look forward to seeing what you can do with it.